lamination system. Today we're going to run through laminating on our Sign Easy Plus Laminator. It's our mid-range machine. Let's get started. I've now placed our laminating film on the back mandrel of our laminator, and I've also placed a cardboard core on our paper take-up mandrel. I'm now going to thread the film under the idler bar and back to the paper taker. I'll now tape this on. My next step from this point is to make a skim cut across the surface of the film. The trick being not to cut through the paper as well. I'll now separate the film from the liner and draw it over the front roller. From that point, I'm going to make a tab out of the film I've just pulled down by pushing it into the open rollers of the laminator. Now it's in the open rollers of the laminator, it is sitting smooth. I'm going to close the rollers of my laminator and start the machine to pull the film. Alright, we're now going to load our print onto the machine. And then the next step from that point is to ensure we've got our print lined up with our laminating film. So I'm bringing print up and checking my lineup with each side. It needs to move slightly to the right. And that's it. Now I'm going to take my print and just attach it onto the tab of film that I had from when I set the machine up at the start. Now we're basically ready to laminate. So I'm going to start the machine slowly, let our print enter the machine. At that point I'm just going to stop and move to the rear of the machine to tape the print onto our take-up mandrel. Now once we're at this point, we want to think a little bit about the setup of our machine. We want the most tension or moderate tension on the laminating film itself. We want minimal tension on our paper taker. It's just got to get the paper out of the way. It doesn't have to pull it off the film. Also with our rewind taker, also minimal tension, just to take up our print. We don't want too many forces all pulling against each other. We really just want to hold our film firmly and collect everything else. All right, now we've got everything connected, we're all set and ready to laminate. I'll just point out a couple of things before I go on. I'm running 30 degrees on this product. Generally between 30 to 40 degrees is what we use on most laminating products. More than 40 degrees and we'll start to see too much distortion in our film. So we want to avoid temperatures much over 40. Also, I will now close my rollers fully, which means I just wind the handle until it stops. And that's all I need to do. These have a balanced nib system and stops inside the machine. You don't gain anything else by pulling any harder on the handle. We're all set up now, ready to go. So I'll press the start button and we'll start laminating. Once I'm happy that everything looks good, it's running smoothly, the film is smooth over the roller, our take-up's working nicely but not too tight, I'll walk around the back and check just that our rewind is collecting everything properly, which it is, and now I can increase the speed my laminator. And that's it, basically. We're set up and laminating. with our print finished and laminated, the one we've just done, what everyone finds happens every day, we now need to swap to a gloss film for the next job, which is different. So what I'm going to show you now is how to tag onto the film that's already in the machine, so we don't have to do the whole setup again. We can basically cheat a little bit and just tag the different film onto our old film and continue laminating. What I need to do for that is I need a piece of scrap. It can either be just waste paper from our paper rewind, a piece of media. We just need something in the machine to stop on. So what I'm going to do is put that into the machine to start. And then stop it again. So what that's done is just let me get the last of our print out to the back of the machine and make sure my bottom roller is masked against any film. So now we'll move around the back, cut the old print off, and cut the film in. Okay, so now around at the back of the machine, we've got our piece of scrap we put in here and our good print underneath. So now I'm just going to separate that off, tape it up, and remove it from the machine to get ready for our next job. Now, like most Sign Master machines, the mandrels are interchangeable from front to rear, top to bottom. So what I'll do is I'll come around and the mandrel that had our job, our print on it, I'll now bring that round to the back and use that to collect our next job. And so then we're now using the mandrel that we took off the rear of the machine to put our next print on and load back onto the machine. At this point, I'm now going to cut the film that's on the machine to get ready to put the next film on. The main thing to remember with your laminator, the rollers are the most important thing in the machine. If your roller gets cut or damaged, it's going to show up on every job you do until you have those rollers replaced. So be very mindful, never use knives or sharp objects to remove film, and definitely try and keep them away from your roller at all costs. I'm now going to cut our release liner from our original roller film. And then I'm going to cut along the fiber bar, keeping away from my roller. And then I'm going to remove our matte film. Place it with our gloss . What we want to do is just remove this one little bit of the release liner left on that roll of film, on the film that's on the machine. I've just rolled that back and removed it. Now we're pretty much doing the same thing as we did on our initial setup, apart from instead of coming around under our idle roller, instead of coming up to our paper taker, which we did last time, we're going to come straight onto the laminating film that's already on the roller. And then we'll just flatten that out. Separate our liner. machine slowly forward. What I'm trying to do is just get enough paper to get to my rewind. And we will stick that to the old release paper. But to do that, we need to use a piece of film or a piece of media. If we use normal tape, like masking tape or whatever type of tape for that matter, it will just let go. So if we use scrap film or scrap media to join that. Next, we need to make sure our lock pins are in our printed mandrel. This just stops any chance of it jumping out, especially when it gets to the end of the print, if it's taped onto the core. Now, I'm just going to check our lineup as we did before. Looks pretty good to me. And then I'm going to use the foot pedal to start the machine. So I'm using two hands, spread right over. I'll start the machine. And you can go down your print. So there we've changed over the film from gloss to matte and run two different jobs with minimal downtime and minimal changeover time. Once again, I'll be Matt from Lamination System. I hope this has been helpful. Thank you for watching.